A big part of setting up the local developer environment in the previous video. Now in this one, we are going to use that particular environment that we set up, and we are going to run the local, run the Django's unit tests on our laptop. Now remember, unit tests take a lot of time to run. So be patient when the unit tests are running, and make sure that you run those unit tests after you make any code changes to Django before you submit your pull request to Django. Because if your tests are failing, ultimately you will hear back on the pull request where people will ask you to ensure that your tests pass. And that doesn't really set up a good reputation with the team, right? It kind of shows that you're not very careful enough. So be mindful to run your tests, not just in Django, in whatever open source project you're contributing. Okay, so I already have the virtual ENV activated, but just to recap on how we did so far, in case there are people who are watching this video directly and didn't see the previous video. So I'm going to deactivate this virtual ENV. To deactivate, we use pyenv deactivate, because I used pyenv to create this virtual ENV in the first place. Now I'm out of this virtual ENV. So my default Python version on my laptop is 2.7.16. Okay. Now we will look at the list of virtual ENVs that we have on this particular laptop. So I have Python 3.8.2 Django dev. That's the one that I want to use for Django developer purpose. So I'm going to copy this name and say pyenv activate this particular virtual ENV, which is py382-django dev. So now I have it activated. Now if I again run Python version, it says Python 3.8.2 instead of 2.7.16. Right. Okay, so now we are in the Django developer version. We are in Python 3.8.2 environment, and we also have Django developer installed. How did we install it? We ran pip install -e, and then we passed the current directory, which is dot, and we did this while we are in the Django folder, right? And it installed it for us. If you want to see the installation, you can just do pip freeze and you will be able to see. So it says -e, and this was the one that was installed, Django, on this particular commit version. Okay, so now we have Python 3.8.2, we have Django installed, we have our virtual ENV activated, and we are all sorted. What next? Next step is to run the unit test. Now to run the unit test, the steps that you follow is you first install the requirements for the unit test. How do you do it? You say pip install -r. And then you pass the requirements. Requirements for Python 3, right? So when you do this and you run, it will go ahead and install all the Python 3 requirements to be able to run the tests on your laptop. Now while this is installing, I would recommend that you go ahead and keep looking at Django's contributing guidelines while you are going through this. So let's say if you are doing unit tests Django, it says unit tests over here. So this is actually showing the exact same thing, right? It's asking you to do pip install -r requirements, which we are just doing now. And the next step will be that we'll actually run the test using this particular command. And there are some really good things over here. You should definitely read this documentation in full, because it will definitely help you when it comes to being a contributor to Django and also understanding how Django's internal functionality works. Right, so we have everything installed over here. Now, next, we need to run the test. Now, how do you run the test? You go to test folder. If you do a ls over here, that wasn't a good choice. So basically, you have runtest.py file. So to run the test, you just run runtest.py. Now before we run the test, so actually let's go ahead and run the test. Now what you will notice is it automatically figures out how many cores do I have in my laptop, and it uses that many cores to run the test in parallel. Now sometimes what happens is when it's trying to run the test in parallel, there are certain failures, because of which I try to run test only without any parallelization. So basically only one particular instance of test is running. In fact, in this case, I think it's already configured. That's why only one is running. Let's look at it. Right, so I press Control C to stop the test. So how do you ensure that only single instance of test run and the test do not run in parallel? So Django uses, there is this environment variable called Django test processes. It's Django underscore test underscore processes. It's process but plural, right? So if I do, I don't have it right now. Okay, so now if I do run test.py, it should run the test as normal. Alright, so while it is running test over here, we'll let it run. Now this will take some time because there are more than 10,000 tests in Django's repository. It takes upwards of 7 to 10 minutes usually, sometimes even more than that. And each dot in the test represents a pass. S represents a skip, which is like this. X, the letter for X-ray, represents expected failure, and F represents failure. So you might see different of these. Now you should not have any failures. If you have any failures and there's some issue which you need to resolve and you get it fixed. The best way to look at any failures is to actually look at this documentation over here. It has troubleshooting guidelines. So for example, if you are facing certain failures of these sort, especially if you're using macOS, you should set this particular environment variable. And then if you run the test, then you should not see those failures anymore. So I have not set that environment variable, I think, I'm not certain, but I think so, because of which we actually might see tests failing right now. But this is going to take some time. Right, so that's how you go ahead and run the test locally. Now the set of steps that we did, just to quickly recap, we went in Django source code directory, which for me is home directory git Django. We activated the virtual environment. In my case, I activated activate py382 Django dev. Right, we verified that we are using the Python version 3.8.2. You can use different Python versions. I'm using 3.8.2. We installed Django using pip install -e dot. I already have it installed. I'm not going to do it again. Then we went to test directory. We install the requirements for tests, which is pip install -r requirements /py3.txt. Again, I already have it installed, so I'm not going to run it again. And then finally, I just ran /runtest.py. In case you notice any failures, again, just go ahead and have a look at this documentation. How did we come to this documentation? You literally search for unit test Django, and it should be right up there. Yeah, that's pretty much it for this particular video. If you see any failures and if you're not able to find answers for this, Stack Overflow is your best friend. Or if I can help, feel free to comment on this video and let me know how I can assist. Thanks for watching this. In the next one, we will look at how to build Django's documentation locally and run it locally so that you can access the documentation offline without the need for internet. Thanks and stay tuned for the next video.